Want to upgrade your Ender 5 in 15 minutes or less using only printable parts? We're going to do that today. My name's Jim, and this is The Edge of Tech. So today we're going to take this Ender 5 and we're going to upgrade it in 15 minutes or less using my three favorite printable upgrades. These help bed strain relief, bed flex, and protect your back cover right here on the LCD. We're going to jump into it. It's real easy. All you have to do before you go any further is jump on Thingiverse. The links are in the description below. Download and print the parts. Then come back to this point in the video and I'm gonna show you how to install them. It's super easy, it only takes 15 minutes or less, and these are some of the best upgrades you can do to your Ender 5, and I would suggest doing them as soon as you get it. Let's do it. So the first one is this right here. This is the LCD cover, and it covers the back of your screen, and this will work on any of the Ender 5s. Along with the Ender 3s, you can print these for the Ender 3s as well. But it's super easy. Once you get it printed, it looks like this. It's really simple. You take it, you put it right here, and you just go ahead and push it down. Now, something to remember is to make sure you have enough of the cable coming out to the back, just to make sure you're not gonna pinch anything. Once you get it that far, just push it through. It'll clip into place. And now your screen is completely protected. When you're moving this or grabbing it, you're not gonna touch the back anymore. Super simple, only took about 10 seconds to push on. And this is something that anybody can do as soon as you print it. Super easy. The next one we're gonna do is this bed strain relief. So I have the Ender 5 turned sideways, and you can see these are the wires that come off the bed. They are not supported in any way, and that is not a good thing. So what you do is you print this. It's a very quick print. It uses some supports underneath. So you take and you push it right here on the frame of the bed. And then as you can see, it should be lined up perfectly with these wires. Now that's gonna hold that up so this doesn't flop around anymore. Then take a small zip tie. One of the extra ones you got with your printer will work great. Push that through. Pull your zip tie on like that. Now this one, you don't wanna be overly tight, but if you do get a little tight, it's okay because this sits in a channel and it's not going to hurt anything. The next thing you have to do is just take the blue snippers you got with your kit and cut that excess off and you're done. So this is now really solid. This isn't going anywhere. So it's going to hold those cables. So when the bed goes up and down, it doesn't hurt the connections underneath here. Now that one was quick and that one is going to save your printer in the long run. The last of the three upgrades that I suggest to do right away are these braces right here. And they come in two pieces. They're gonna print with this, and they're gonna print with this. And eventually that's gonna go together on the back and hold it there. But as you can see, this goes against right here, just like that. And it holds onto the bed like this. And you just push it on and it'll hold itself there. It does have right hand and left hand when you print them, so that helps a lot. So you want to make sure this piece is pushed all the way in. And then if you look back here, this is sitting all the way against that bar right here. And you're going to do that on both sides. These are the braces, the supports that we just printed. And each one of them will say right and left. As you can see, this is the left one. And it'll print a cap like this. And you will also need 8 M4 nuts and 8 M4 by 20 screws. So when you're ready, you're gonna take your M4 nuts and you're gonna stage them in the slots that printed out right there. Now that you have the arm on, take the back plate and it can only go on one way. If you put it on backwards, it won't fit right and it won't look right. So put it on the correct way, which is this way here. Then take your M20 bolt, push it through the hole until you find that nut, and with the Allen wrench that came with the kit, tighten that in. I like to push mine up, so it's up a little bit higher here, So tighten that in until it's snug, and then flip it to the small side of the Allen wrench and do your final tightening with the small side of the Allen wrench. Do that for these three, follow those steps on the other side, and we'll be done. You'll have both arms on each side here. You'll have the bed strain relief, the bed strain support here, and the cover on your LCD right here. It was super easy to do, 15 minutes or less after you got the parts printed. One thing that I really like about this is these arms here, the reason why we do this is to stop this bed from flexing. Now, I haven't had a lot of experience with that flexing myself, but I did these because a lot of people saw when you got something really heavy on your bed would flex because it's a cantilever. It's only connected back here. It's only, you know, a single Z. It's not like an Ender 5 Plus where it has dual Z. So these things really help, and it's really rigid now. I mean, you really have to crank that bad boy down to make it flex. That's not gonna break these wires anymore because this is sturdy. And when your bed goes up and down, this isn't flopping around in the wind. And you're not gonna touch the back of your panel because now you've covered it up. So we just went over three really simple printable upgrades that you should do right away when you get your Ender 5. If you've had it for a while, you should do them too. I really like these upgrades because they don't take much to put them on. The worst thing you have to do is find those M4 by 20 bolts and those M4 nuts. I really like using the little kits that you can buy. I'll have those in the link down below. You can get them from TH3D, you can get them from Amazon, but they come with M3, M4, M5 bolts and nuts and all sorts of different size bolts. So with that being said, you know, this was a super easy install. The longest part about this is actually printing the parts, but after the parts are printed, this is 15 minutes or less to really upgrade your Ender 5. And you're not changing the mechanics, so you're not changing out a hot end or an extruder or anything like that. So when you get your Ender 5 and you're learning how to use it, before you do any of those mechanical changes, I would really suggest doing these printable changes first. The other cool thing is that since they're all printable, you can do them in any colors you want. I chose the blue for this one. I really like blue. I've done other colors on my other two just to tell them apart. But you can choose any color. You can do, this is PLA. I printed these all in PLA. You can use PETG, you can use ABS if you want. I like PLA, it's rigid, it's strong, it's not going anywhere. So that's what I prefer. It does not touch anywhere where it's hot, so you don't have to worry about it warping, which is a good thing. And it's the best thing is it's cheap, it's easy to learn how to print with, and if it's one of your first prints with the Ender 5, you can do it. Well, I hope you learned something today, and as always, keep printing. Hey everybody, I hope you liked the video today. If you did, give me that thumbs up. Click that subscribe button right here. There's a little bell right over here if you want to get the notifications when the next great videos or live streams come on. I really appreciate your support. You guys rock.